Casimir IV Jagiellon. Casimir IV KG of the Jagiellonian dynasty was Grand Duke of Lithuania from 1440 and King of Poland from 1447, until his death. He was one of the most active Polish rulers, under whom Poland, by defeating the Teutonic Knights in the 13 Years' War, recovered Pomerania, and the Jagiellonian dynasty became one of the leading royal houses in Europe. He was a strong opponent of aristocracy, and helped to strengthen the importance of Parliament and the Senate. The great triumph of his reign was bringing Prussia under Polish rule. The long and brilliant rule of Casimir corresponded to the age of new monarchies in Western Europe. By the 15th century, Poland had narrowed the distance separating it from Western Europe and become a significant factor in international relations. The demand for raw materials and semi-finished goods stimulated trade, producing a positive balance, and contributed to the growth of crafts and mining in the entire country. He was a recipient of the English Order of the Garter, the highest order of chivalry and the most prestigious honor in England. Casimir Jagiellon was the third and youngest son of King Władysław II Jagiello and his fourth wife, Sophia of Halsany. His father was already 65 at the time of Casimir's birth, and his brother Władysław III, 3 years his senior, was expected to become king before his majority. Strangely, little was done for his education. He was never taught Latin, nor was he trained for the responsibilities of office, despite the fact he was the only brother of the rightful sovereign. He often relied on his instinct and feelings and had little political knowledge, but shared a great interest in the diplomacy and economic affairs of the country. Throughout Casimir's youth, Bishop Zbigniew Olsznicki was his mentor and tutor. However, the cleric felt a strong reluctance towards him, believing that he would be an unsuccessful monarch following Władysław's death. The sudden death of Sigismund Kęstutis left the office of the Grand Duchy of Lithuania empty. The voivode of Trakai, Jonas Gostautas, and other magnates of Lithuania, supported Casimir as a candidate to the throne. However, many Polish noblemen hoped that the 13-year-old boy would become a vice-regent for the Polish king in Lithuania. Casimir was invited by the Lithuanian magnates to Lithuania, and when he arrived in Vilnius in 1440, he was proclaimed as the Grand Duke of Lithuania on June 29, 1440 by the Council of Lords, contrary to the wishes of the Polish noble lords, an act supported and coordinated by Jonas Gostautas. When the news arrived in the Kingdom of Poland concerning the proclamation of Casimir as the Grand Duke of Lithuania, it was met with hostility, even to the point of military threats against Lithuania. Since the young Grand Duke was underage, the supreme control over the Grand Duchy of Lithuania was in the hands of the Council of Lords, presided by Jonas Gostautas. Casimir had been taught Lithuanian language and the customs of Lithuania by appointed court officials. During Casimir's rule, the rights of the Lithuanian nobility, dukes, magnates and boyars, irrespective of their religion and ethnicity, were put on an equal footing to those of the Polish Szlachta. Additionally, Casimir promised to protect the Grand Duchy's borders and not to appoint persons from the Polish kingdom to the offices of the Grand Duchy. He accepted that decisions on matters concerning the Grand Duchy would not be made without the Council of Lords' consent. He also granted the subject region of Sąjūdis the right to elect its own elder. Casimir was the first ruler of Lithuania baptized at birth, becoming the first native Roman Catholic Grand Duke. Casimir succeeded his brother Władysław III as King of Poland after a 3-year interregnum on June 25, 1447. In 1454, he married Elizabeth of Austria, daughter of the late King of the Romans Albert II of Habsburg, by his late wife Elizabeth of Bohemia. Her distant relative Frederick of Habsburg became Holy Roman Emperor and reigned as Frederick III until after Casimir's own death. The marriage strengthened the ties between the House of Jagiellon and the sovereigns of Hungary, Bohemia, and put Casimir at odds with the Holy Roman Emperor through internal Habsburg rivalry. That same year, Casimir was approached by the Prussian Confederation for aid against the Teutonic Order, which he promised by making the separatist Prussian regents a protectorate of the Polish kingdom. However, when the insurgent cities rebelled against the order, it resisted and the 13 Years' War ensued. Casimir and the Prussian Confederation defeated the Teutonic Order, entering its abandoned capital at Marienburg. In the Second Peace of Thorn, the order recognized Polish sovereignty over the seceded Western Prussian regions, Royal Prussia, and the Polish crown's overlordship over the remaining Teutonic monastic state, transformed in 1525 into a duchy, Ducal Prussia. Elizabeth's only brother Ladislaus, King of Bohemia and Hungary, died in 1457, and after that Casimir and Elizabeth's dynastic interests were directed also towards her brother's former kingdoms. King Casimir IV died on June 7, 1492 in the old Grodno Castle in the Grand Duchy of Lithuania, which was in a personal union with Poland. The intervention of the Roman Curia, which hitherto had been hostile to Casimir because of his steady and patriotic resistance to papal aggression, was due to the permutations of European politics. The Pope was anxious to get rid of the Hussite King of Bohemia, George Podbrad, as the first step towards the formation of a league against the Turk. Casimir was to be a leading factor in this combination, and he took advantage of it to procure the election of his and Vladislaus II as King of Bohemia. But he would not commit himself too far, and his ulterior plans were frustrated by the rivalry of Matthias Corvinus, King of Hungary, who even went so far as to stimulate the Teutonic Order to rise against Casimir. The death of Matthias in 1490 was a great relief to Poland, and Casimir employed the two remaining years of his reign in consolidating his position still further. Around 1480 he was allied with the Great Horde against Muscovy in Crimea. His failure to support Konigmed at the Great Stand on the Uger River contributed to Russia's gaining its independence from the steppe nomads. In domestic affairs Casimir was relatively passive but anxious to preserve the prerogatives of the crown, notably his right to nominate bishops. In the question of territories in dispute between his two states he favored Lithuania. During the war against the Teutonic Order he was forced to grant the Polish nobility substantial concessions by the privilege of Nisawa. These, however, became important only after his death, and royal power was not greatly diminished during his lifetime. The feature of Casimir's character which most impressed his contemporaries was his extraordinary simplicity and sobriety. He, one of the greatest monarchs in Europe, habitually wore plain cloth from Krakow, drank nothing but water, and kept the most austere of tables. His one passion was the chase. Yet his liberality to his ministers and servants was proverbial, and his vanquished enemies he always treated with magnificent generosity. Casimir was neither a splendid ruler nor a good and wise administrator, but a mistrusting, cautious, and sober head of a large family who regarded Lithuania as his personal estate. However, his reign was remembered as being both successful and the most peaceful in the history of Poland. During Casimir's rule the cultural progress was striking, with the reconstituted and enlarged University of Krakow playing a major role. Humanist trends found a promoter at Krakow in the Italian scholar Filippo de Bonacorsi, known as Callimachus. From the pen of Jan de Lugos came the first major, Royal History of Poland. The remains of King Casimir IV and his wife Elizabeth were interred in a tomb situated in a chapel of the Wawel Castle in Krakow, Poland. With the consent of then Cardinal Karol Wojtyla, a team of scientists was given permission to open the tomb and examine the remains, with restoration as the ultimate objective. Casimir's tomb was opened on Friday, April 13, 1973. 12 researchers were present. Inside the tomb they found a wooden coffin that was heavily rotted. It contained what was left of the king's decayed corpse. Within a few days, four of the 12 scientists and researchers had died. Not long after, there were only two survivors, Dr. Boleslav Smyk, a microbiologist, and Dr. Edward Rosicki. Smyk was to suffer problems with his equilibrium for the next 5 years. In the course of his microbiological examinations, Smyk found traces of fungi on the royal insignia taken from the tomb. He identified three species, Aspergillus flavus, Penicillium rubrum, and Penicillium rugulosum. These fungi are known to produce aflatoxins that can be deadly when in contact with skin and inhaled into the lungs. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.